Hey YouTube, what is up everybody? How's it going? This is your homeboy, Top 4. I have not done a video like this in a long time with the talking in it. Other than my weapons video that I have on my computer in the kitchen, around my kitchen slash computer desk area, office area, where I have it in my trailer. But like I said, I've been busy lately. My grandpa's in the hospital right now. I haven't really been making a whole lot of videos because I've been trying to help my grandma out and everything else. But I'm going to get a workout video in for y'all tonight. I'm trying to go back to calisthenics since summer. I'm trying to lose the weight a little bit since I noticed I'm kind of getting a little bit of a gut on me. So I'm trying to go back to doing calisthenics more. Basically, you know, work on that. I still do weightlifting, you know, on the side. I mean, I'm down to like 3 days a week from weightlifting. I mean, I don't do it as much as I used to because I'm not really trying to get big. I'm just trying to do it just to look good, feel good, and that's all I'm doing it for. I'm not really trying to impress anybody. That's the reason why I don't really lift too heavy in none of my videos. I just do just get a quick pump in, you know, just get in, get done, stay motivated at all times. And that's the thing, tendency to work out to, you know, get your mind off things. Your tendency to work out to get your mind off things. That's what working out is good for you. If you like my content, please hit the subscribe button on the left hand side of the screen on the bottom there. And hit that bell notification, hit the like on the video, it'll help the algorithm out on my continent. Please leave a comment down below on this video. I'm going to do, I want to say a boxing cardio workout. My channel is about martial arts and fitness all around. So I'm going to get a quick sip of my water here and I'm going to get into working out. And then here I am going to be doing this video for you. What we'll probably do is some boxing techniques, probably some leg work, and basically like squats, lunges, maybe jumping jacks, just do like basic stuff, you know, just get in shape and everything. And you know, cardio is the best thing, you know, if you want to get in. I just picked 3 different exercises, plus I had I'll add some hand techniques on the side, and that way I just get a good sweat on. You know, prisoners, they do this kind of sort of stuff inside the prison. There's a lot of YouTubers out there that are from prison that make these type of videos, and not really on martial arts, but on calisthenics themselves. And you know, like Big Boy, he does it. Moses Cuevas, he does it. Sean G, he does it. Those three guys, you know, they got out of prison. They made their name big on YouTube. And so, me, I'm not really from prison. You know, I just like how their workout ethics are because they motivate them people. You know, how they stay in shape, they kind of motivate me to get in shape really good. Because that's all they have at the top of the world is working out. Where if you work a 40-hour work week like I do, you can't work out 48, you can't work out 8 hours a day. And, you know, if I get in an hour, I'm happy. I mean, if that's all I have time for, an hour, I'm good. On the weekends, I might train 2 hours, you know, because, or sometimes 3, I might divide the hours up. You know, I don't do it all in one setting. And that's the thing. You know, you can break it all up into little pieces of the day. Even if you do 30 minutes here, then do another 30 minutes later on. And then just break it up. And then count how many reps you do in each 30 minutes. And just build your way up to an hour of your time, and then there you go. You got some training. But you always gotta stay motivated, baby. You always gotta stay motivated. That's all you gotta do. In the mind. The mind, the eyes, the heart, everything. That's the only thing about being a warrior. You know, you gotta train your body to become one. You know, you gotta train your body to become one. That's what I believe in, honor. Honor is the way of the warrior. You know, you gotta have honor in the way you train. So, that's all I'm saying. Jabs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. All I want to say is the reason why I'm turning my legs. In boxing, that's what they use. And same with Taekwondo, that's what they use. Karate people, that's what they use. They use their legs. They also use their hands too. But without the core being strong, they can't fight. So that's the reason why I'm training my legs today. One, two, three, four. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 15, 17, 18, 20. Then we're going to do a number two combination, jab cross. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, Now, if you don't know how to punch, go back to my old videos. In one of my old videos on how to throw a reverse punch. If you don't know the basics of throwing a punch, go back to that video. Learn off of it. On throwing the right proper punch. I'm going to do jab, cross, hook. That is a number three combination. When you turn on one side, you must turn on the other side. That's what makes a perfect martial artist, a perfect fighter. You turn on both sides, you gotta get both sides equally trained. You can't just be a one-sided fighter. If you are, you must train the other side. That is round three. I'm on round four. Thank you. we're doing the number four combination. Which is a jab, cross, hook, cross, jab, cross, hook, cross. First two. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. That's round four. Now we're on round five. Doing 20 reps of everything. If you haven't noticed, this is a jab, cross, uppercut. That's number five. One, two, three. And you notice when I'm doing the technique, I'm breathing. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Something. 18. 19. 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. And what we're going to do on the five other reps, just do the same thing. You just repeat it all the way up to the jab cross uppercut, which is a number five number combination. And you do it 10 times, 10 sets. And you just repeat it five more times. And I'll tell you what, that's 200 reps of everything if you do 20 reps. I mean, you get a good sweat on. I'm already getting a good sweat on already as it is. So I'm wearing like jogging sweat, like sweat warmer pants on. Plus I have the heat on in here, even though it's not cold out. I have the heat cranked up where I can get really sweaty in here. So I'm trying to burn fat because I'm trying to get rid of this. So that's the reason why I'm doing cardio today. And, you know, kind of get my endurance up again a little bit more better. This is the sixth round. Now, if you need a water break, go ahead and take a water break. That's it. You know, if you need a water break, go ahead and take a water break. If you're a beginner, you're more intermediate, you know, you can last a little longer without the water, and go right ahead. Now we're on round seven. jab cross. This is round 8. Now we're going to do is jab cross hook. Chin tucked in. Instead of having it up, keep it tucked in. Only karate fighters and Taekwondo people, they had their chin up more. But boxers, that's what I love about boxing, because it keeps your chin protected at all times. You never want to get hit with an uppercut or a hook on the jaw if it's up. One, know, you gotta have that mind frame in order to get it right, you know. You gotta have that mind frame to get it right. Look, fearless, ride hard. You know, you gotta be fearless. You know, you gotta be able to ride hard in these workouts. You know, I have a tiger. You gotta have the eye of a tiger mentality when you are training to become a fighter. This is the last set of the 10th one. And what we're gonna do at the end of it, we're gonna get in the horse stance from Taekwondo and Karate. We're gonna do reverse punches. We're gonna do them 20 times. And so I'll show you what I'm gonna be doing. Thank you. into horse stance. Have our hands on our hips, on our waist here. Have them tucked in. Make a fist. And then we're gonna do reverse punches 20 times. There you have it, folks. A boxing mixed with a little bit of karate and taekwondo and combined. I just do this video type of sort of videos, and once in a while I don't do them all the time. But so like I said, if you want to get in shape, do this workout. Do it for 30 minutes, 20 minutes, however long you can do it. If you do a whole hour of it, that's great, man. I pat you on the back. But it's like I said, you gotta have that eye of a tiger mentality. You gotta have that mindset. You just can't do this, you know, work out one day out of the week, and then, or work out 2 days out of the week. You know, you gotta stay consistent with it if you want results. I'm telling you, you know, you just can't turn it off whenever you wanna turn it up. You just can't turn it on whenever you wanna turn it on. You just gotta stay with it. You gotta stay with it. That's what I'm doing. I'm trying to stay with it, you know. That's the reason why I've been, you know, moving around. Now, doing my shadow boxing. Because shadow boxing is a good workout, too. You know, shadow boxing is a great workout. I mean, once you get all these movements down, then that's what you can work on by mixing it up. Now, it don't have to be in order. You know, work on your footwork a little bit. Your head movement. Walking, stuff like that. That's the reason why I like boxing so much. Even though they say boxing is not a martial art, I don't care what people say. I do not care what people say. Boxing is the number one American martial art. I said the military uses it. The Marines uses it. You know, like in ancient times, they used it, and they're on their battlefield. So really, technically, boxing is the number one martial art. I don't really care what anybody says. That's what I believe. That's the reason why I like boxing, because it's more easier. I mean, you don't have a whole lot of training doing kicks and everything. You know, I like to do kicks, don't get me wrong. But really, technically, can you really use the kicks in the street fight? You can, but you gotta kick low. You can't really kick high, because if you do kick high, they're gonna want to catch. That's the only reason why I don't really like to kick all that much. I mean, kicking gets good drills to, you know, get a good workout in your legs. That's what I really use them for. But usually, my kicks are there. My kicks are there. And everything. They're there and everything. When I need them. But, so that's it. I like to stay simple, direct, and fighting. That's just me. 7 down 4, signing out. Please hit the like, hit subscribe, hit that bell notification, hit all of the bell notification, hit the lights, help the algorithm out, put my comment in, leave a comment down below saying you sure had this workout, and God bless you on this beautiful day, and peace out.